Okay, we're starting on the solutions to chapter 7. These are the first three problems of the chapter, and really the reason why I assigned these is just so you get used to using those four charts we discussed in the lecture, the present value, the future value, the present value annuity, and the future value annuity charts. Of course, when you look at the the assignment description, calculate the following future values. You know you're going to use either a future value or a future value annuity chart. I'll point out keywords as we move along. One thing I will tell you is when I'm doing these, when I'm writing future value problems for you on the test, and you'll see this on the study guide, I'll say if you invest $10,000 today, so you'll be looking for today and invest, or if you have $10,000 and you put it in the bank, as an example, then you know you're investing it if it's in the bank. What will you have in 5 years at 8%, as an example? So we're looking at a future value because it's $10,000 today. It's just a single cash flow, so we don't use the annuity table, we just use the FV table, and I signify that by putting FV. So the first thing I do whenever I'm working any time value money problems is I write out the problem as a problem or as a solution, I guess. So I have 10,000 times FV times parentheses 5 years at 8%. So that tells me I need to open up to the FV table and go to 5 years and look down at 8%. And I see that multiplier of 1.4693. I do my math and I get $14,693 in future value because you're investing. Your numbers always get larger. So if you have a number of less than $10,000 here, it ought to be an automatic cue that you've done something very, very wrong. On problem two, it's the same kind of format as one. We need to go to the future value table and go to 10 years at 10%. And again, I wrote it out as $50,000 times FV, parentheses 10 years, 10%. When we look at that future value table at 10 years and go down to 10%, we see the multiplier of 2.5937. So we do our math, we multiply $50,000 by the multiplier, and we get $129,685. Problems 3 and 4 are both annuities, and we know this because after the number, so the 5,000 you see per year means that we're going to have multiple cash flows. Again, in the parentheses, it says beginning at the end of the first year. The reason why the text says that is because in later chapters, and you will need to address this in later chapters, we're going to have cash flows that start on time period zero and some that start at the beginning of or at the end of the year, which is actually the same thing as the beginning at the end of the first year. But for chapter 7, chapter 10, and chapter 6, you won't have to worry about that, so you can go straight to the book and use the formula without any adjustments. All right, so we have $500 that we're putting in the bank at the end of the year for 6 years at 6%, and that tells us that we need to go to the future value of annuity table. So if you see, I wrote our formula 500 times FEA for 6 years at 6%. We go and we look down at 6 years, or find 6 years, and it's actually six periods. We will be using periods, but our periods are years right now, so don't worry about that. And you go down and you see that 6.9753. We do our math 500 times the multiplier, and we get $3,487.65. It's exactly the same problem for four, with the exception of the numbers. So we have $1,500 times FVA for 12 years at 12%. We're going to go to the FVA table again and go to 12 years, look down at 12%, and we got that 24.133. We multiply it by 1,500. We get $36,199.50. So we've done two future value problems, two future value annuity problems now. 7.2 is present value. Now we know we need to look at either the PV or the PVA table, depending on the problem. The first problem says that we get $5,000 8 years from now. So that's a single cash flow in the future. We want to know what it's worth today. So we go ahead and multiply the 5,000 by the present value at 8 years and 8%. When we go to the table for present value of a single cash flow and look for 8 years at 8%, we get 0.5403. We do our math and it's $2,701.50. A lot of times, as in this problem, you see where it says discounted. That's just a reminder that the number is going to be worth less today than in the future. That's because of the time value of money. You know, you can invest that money today, and in 8 years, you can invest it at a rate of 8% in this problem, it'll be worth $5,000. It works both ways. So if you come out with a number that's larger than 5,000 when you do a present value, you know you've gone to the wrong table. Problem two is just like problem one, different numbers. So we have $10,000 times PV at 5 years at 6%. We go to the present value table on 201 and look at 5 years, go down to 6%, we get 0.7473. We do our math, and $10,000 in 5 years today is worth $7,472.58. Again, it's smaller than the 10,000 because it was discounted. Money today is worth less than money in the future. Now, 3 and 4 are like kind of like 3 and 4 on problem 7-1, except for their present value and their per year. So we see the $8,000 per year. We know that that means that it's an annuity. We want to know what $8,000 per year is worth today. So basically what would happen is, let's assume that you've got a settlement and you're getting $8,000 a year for 4 years, or I hate to say this, but maybe a divorce, and you were and you wanted to know what you had to pay today, or what you could take today as a lump sum, as opposed to getting the $8,000 a year for 4 years. You could do this math, and now in today's time, I don't think you can get the 12%, but let's hope you can. So $8,000 times PVA for 4 years at 12%. The multiplier for that is 3.0373. So if you were to take $24,298.40 today, it would be the same thing of getting 4 years of $8,000 when taking into consideration time value of money. The second one is $4,000 a year, and this one is for 6 years at 10%. Again, I always go ahead and write out $6,000 times PVA for 6 years and 10%. And then I do the math, and it's $26,000, $131.80. The multiplier was 4.3553. All four of these problems should have been pretty straightforward, from 7-1 to 7-2. This one right here, I'm just going to let you know, everybody so far in all my classes have gotten it wrong. And I expect you all to get it wrong, and I just hope that you understand conceptually the solution. I used to tease students and say, if anybody can get this problem right, I'd give them an A in the class. And of course, thank God nobody has gotten it right and just been able to walk away. So I don't say that anymore. I didn't give you all that challenge. If you got it right, I'm sorry that you weren't in the class when I made that wager. Okay, so what we have is we have three years of cash flows from in time period 1, 2, and 3. So in years 1, 2, and 3, we're getting $4,000. And then for another 5 years, we're getting $3,000. So we're getting 8 years of cash flows, 4 years at $3,000, and then 3 years at $5,000. Well, there's two ways to look at this. The first way to look at it is that you, when I see the $4,000, I actually see $3,000 plus $1,000. So if we were to break up that $3,000 to $3,000 plus $1,000, then we have two annuities that start in time period 0 and go on into the future. The first one is a $1,000 annuity, and that goes on for 3 years. So if you look at the second half of the first problem, you have the plus $1,000 times PVA for 3 years and 8%. And then the first part is the $3,000 for 8 years, and we have the PVA for $3,000 for 8 years at 8%. Now, what a lot of students want to do is they want to actually go ahead and, well, actually, let me show you that on the next slide. So one thing that we haven't done yet is we haven't had two different cash flows, and what we can do is we can just add them together. So you see that I've added those two together. One thing you want to make sure of course, is that you do your multiplication first. So we look up the multipliers for 8 years at 8% and 3 years at 8%, and we have the formula 3,000 times 5.7466 plus 1,000.25771 equals 19,816.90. The present value of these cash flows is almost $20,000. Okay, oops, I didn't have another slide. Let's go back and let's just talk conceptually about this right here. And I'll explain to you what most students want to do. Most students want to do $4,000 times PVA for 3 years at 8%, and then do $3,000 for 5 years at 8%. Now, when you do the multiplication for the 4,000, your first cash flow is zero in year one, and you're bringing it forward to time period zero. Well, when you do that math for the $3,000, you're actually bringing that first cash flow in time period four to time period three. So you have to do another calculation. And that's why it doesn't work out. If you are having trouble with this problem as far as conceptually understanding how it needs to be done, let me know, and we can talk over the phone and I can explain to it better. If you want, we can email each other back and forth. You're not going to have a problem like this on the test. This is more just to get you thinking about cash flows and time value of money and the way that the formulas work and the multipliers work. Okay. I'll